say when. Hi, this moth was actually found on the wall on my second to last day working here in Nyankunde at the hospital. This moth died, fell on the floor, and I found it and picked it up. It's a beautiful entity that you have seen, and somewhere there's a story behind it. I don't know what it is, but we'll find it. Now, so that those of you know that know me, I have been here in Nyankunde, laying the floor on the hospital for the last 3.5 weeks. I finished yesterday and I leave tomorrow. This room that you are looking at right now is the IC unit that is used in the hospital. It took me 2 full days to pour it. These days were 13 hours and 10 hours consecutively. A lot of work, a lot of sweat went into it. In addition, there are 2 additional rooms off to the side that are used for different, I think they will be actually private bed chambers for those that need intensive care that are probably recovering from particular surgeries. From here, let us go into some of the other rooms. As you can see, there are still people working outside, removing a tree trunk whose roots would probably cause damage to the foundation of the hospital were it to remain. Sanitary. It's very important in a hospital that a floor is like that. You'll notice that the walls have been plastered. This was done by the people that were trained to do so. The last time I was here, though I was not the trainer, these people have been learning to plaster walls and do it smoothly because once it's painted, once again, these things need to be easily cleaned. Besides there being light on the roof, there's also windows that will accommodate outside light coming in because we can't use the generator all the time because it would be a waste of energy. Here we have this little area that is obviously set up so that they can have a sink if they need to be washing their hands or washing instruments that are going to be used for the people that are out in the intensive care unit. As well, there is electricity set up in the walls. To be connected so they can turn the light switches on and other things such as if they need to shave or things of that nature. Over here, I think it's where they keep some of the storage for the sheets and for the beds that are going to be used. So like if they need pillowcases, things of that nature, that's going to be used for storage. For this, I believe, is going to be kind of like a dispensary for medication. There are other rooms that each has their own specific purpose. Once again, there are plenty of restrooms. Here is another restroom. At the end, there is a commode, and on the right, there is a sink and more storage space for bed sheets and things of that nature. If you want to take a look inside of there, you can see that the sink would be on one side over there, and you would use the other side as a little closet chamber and space for the sheets and things of that nature. So a lot of design work has been implemented to make accommodation for storage and space that is planned for efficiency. Again, I don't know what this room is for, but there are plenty of rooms that have specific purposes. Oh, wait a minute, I do know. This is an isolation room for the women. On this side, if a woman comes in and she has something like Ebola and she needs to be isolated from other people, this room is going to be for the women of that nature. On the other side is the same thing, but this side is for men. It seems to be a little bit smaller. It also has its own commode facility so that the people who are in isolation can be self-sufficient in terms of using their restrooms without infecting other people. Now, as we come down into this area, you have a hallway that goes out into the back area. That back is an access by the doctors and the nurses. Like if they want to go and take a break, they can do so outside without interrupting and be distracting the people in here. There's a sidewalk that goes in either direction. As well as on that end, there is a room that houses the electricity panel, as well as access to the attic. In the front is a foyer. This is the area where people come in. They will be processed here, and anything that they need to do will be handled at this point, and then they will be directed to wherever they have to go. There are still a few more rooms in this area. My understanding is this is actually a private quarters for a person who has the money can come in here and get specific care, and they will have their own chamber here. This here is a place where the doctors and the nurses, as they come in, can change and go in and shower and clean up, because it has a shower as well as a commode. And there is one on the other side as well. One is for women and one is for men. Exactly the location for which I don't know for sure. Oh, this is the one for women on this side. Excuse me. And the nice part about it is it has two doors. I think that there will be a central panel here where they have windows and swinging doors that are metal that will accommodate and open up to people that go back in that area. And of course, that way people who are not expected to go back there are not going to be taken back there. They can come in from this direction and then have access to the showers or the commode. Moving along. As we come into this area here, we start getting into the serious area because this is the beginning of the operating rooms. Here's where, I don't remember what the purpose of this particular room is, but I believe that it's storage and keeping of medicine and equipment. As you can see, there's an area over there set back so that they can have a sink again. So I'm sure this is one of the operating rooms. What's beautiful about this particular hospital is there are a series of operating rooms that everybody wants to be able to have a specialty in, whether it be an eye surgery. There's a lot of prenatal care, and for that matter, a lot of C-sections that'll be done at this hospital because a lot of the people in this area have a pelvic scenario that is genetic, and it makes it difficult for them to give birth. As a result thereof, about a third of the women here, if they do not have a C-section, die in childbirth. Let us come underneath here where I am bringing on the staff room. And this is the room where the majority of the operating rooms are. As you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 operating rooms. And these rooms, that room in the center there, is used for the sterilization of the instruments, such as scalpels and things of that area. So like if a doctor wants to come in and put in our scalpels, this would be the place that it would be cleaner to get some new clean ones that have been sterilized. And here we have Sammy and Bienvenue that are painting the ceilings. And this is what is referred to as the number one operating room, or OR, if you will. And as you can see, everything is being painted sterile and white. The floors have been done, the walls have been done, the painting, the ceilings. Once the painting is done, the electricity will be done, and then the doors will be applied around here, and the steel doors have been made and ready to install. It's just a matter of now finishing up, and my work is done.